Welcome to Dartsman's Key Secret Life.
We now join Stephen, James and Richard Conroy for the headlines on News at 10.
Would you fuck off? Am I said to go in the fucking oven? Feel in my heart.
David Deal makes an appeal to retrieve his flatmate's belongings. Matty Creighton shocks Newcastle with a secret confession. Marcus Mitchell surprises Damien, the man of his dreams. Is Tesco star Callum Richardson has found a faster answer to budget taxis.
Good evening from Gateshead. Drag artist, actor and legend to the gay circuit, Mr. David Deal made an appeal to Facebook tonight after his housemate James had his items stolen last night. If anyone knows or thinks who may be the culprit may be, then you're urged to contact their local police department. There is a cash reward to catch the thief, which will lead to the recovery of the missing items. The items stolen will be coming up on your screen. 1-inch light up sparkle unicorn dildo, 1 gimp gag mask, it has a sequin finish, 1 large tube of tuna flavoured lube, 1 cucumber, 1 signed photograph of David Dickinson, 1 latex glove with novelty fingers, 1 rope, 1 bag of cable ties, 1 pair of nipple tassels, 1 roll of gaffer tape, 1 anal butt plug, 2 pink fur lined handcuffs, 1 deluxe inflatable goat. Staying on David Deal, we asked him to clarify rumours if he is a massive fan of RuPaul's Drag Race.
No, it's not. It's not one of my favourite shows at all, no.
And good evening from North Shields. Newcastle gay scene's Richard and Judy couple, John and Rachel Creighton, had the most shocking news from one of their sons, Matty, tonight. Happily married Matty decided to go live on Facebook and do some Diana Ross camp cabaret, much to the bemusement of his missus.
Well, to know, got to let it show. I'm coming out. I want the world to know, got to let it show. I'm coming out, and I just want to live complete on you. Come on for me, break out of the shell into a scream that I'm coming out. I'm coming out. I want the world to know, got to let it shine.
Yeah, that's
good. One of Facebook's most popular live bloggers, Marcus Mitchell, has shared a secret on his loaf life. Marcus, who's 22 from down south end, ended up chatting to a mystery man called Damien, invited Damien to his place while his mother was out at work. We can go over to Marcus. Hello Marcus, tell the viewers on this big surprise.
Hello everyone, so I've decided that I'm gonna call my boyfriend and then I'm gonna make him jump, okay? Stay. Damien! Oh, wait. I forgot I don't have a boyfriend.
Mark Chisholm has upgraded his vapor. The 21-year-old who packed in smoking 9 years ago and has not once looked back for temptation shows News at 10 his smoke mag vape and is over the moon. Our foul language correspondent is live here for us now.
Right, I've been asked to do a video, so I'm going to have to do one. I'm absolutely stinking of a vape. So, do to go on from the old crappy shisha one that I had, which I made as a silk cut one. I now have three mods. I have the Mag V8, looks like a gun trigger, which is canny. I have the Nunchaku, and I have another one, and I have another one. I can't say it, Nunchaku. And I've soaked out the shitty gingerbread flavour or peach lemonade. Actually, peach lemonade's not that bad. So, we have this one which has nearly run out. We need to get three. Spot on. And then I have the gun trigger one, but I haven't got the battery in. So, gone are the days of smoking. It's been 8 years since I've smoked. And gone are the days of having shitty, crappy, silk cut, fucking fire, bloody stick shit. Here's the fucking V-Mag 8. Mind of an hour. V-Mag 8. Or the Nunchaku. Definitely the Nunchaku. Anywho, see you in a bit. Ciao. To continue, I forgot to fucking put the bit of the pipe in. I've got all these fucking vapes and I haven't even bothered with the pipe. So, here's to all you green smokers. I'm fucking in the club now. Spot on. In a bit.
Miss Tesco star Callum Richardson and fiancé Mr. Ricky Wright has booked a budget taxi to Wallsend's High Street. Say to hear that Callum and the Hit of Spice dance moves, Ricky were off work and decided to check into the Duke of York for a few bevvies. Co-manager Josh told Callum to cancel the taxi and will send a special transport to pick them up.
Callum, taxi's here.
There's a budget here, yes.
There's like a budget helicopter. I'll seize it. Bye, pals.
I just want to point out, this report is 100% fictional, and on a serious note, News at 10 would like to give the Air Ambulance Service a massive mention and dedicate a team of medics who work with tireless staff to ensure the safety of people in very dire consequences.
Mr. Kevin Richards, on the face of Kev Feeding advert, celebrates being another year older. Kevin revisited his old pal and Facebook hubby, Mr. Sean Young, and dared Kevin to do a video post which could attract gay men, despite being straight and having a girlfriend.
Sutherland's Lucy Purr in Newcastle, Danny DeLonghi and Katina and Pell Dash appeared on a tour bus of RuPaul's Drag Race just before the pandemic started last summer. All four drag queens are big fans of RuPaul's Drag Race and decided to pose to the Manchester gay scene crowd and send them their best regards. In order, left to right, Lucy, Delanco, Katina and Pebble Dash. Velvet Snatch sent us this report.
Wilde has insisted she must talk about face masks, as it is compulsory in Australia to wear them when going out. Kelly describes the face masks as like trying to put on a condom 6 months after finding out you're pregnant. or shutting the gate after the horse has bolted, or even brushing your teeth after they've all fallen out. Kelly reports on how she is not going to be caught out and she wears her own brand of face masks.
People are feeling a little crazy. Yeah, the world has gone mad. Oh, mad, I tell you. And I tell you what, you've got to go out everywhere now with a face mask. A face mask. You've got to cover up everything that you do. I can't even tell you. It's truth. Yeah, you've got to get covered up, but I'm not going to get fooled. I tell you, I have devised a plan. I'm going to wear two face masks. Here's one I made earlier.
Vicky Paris was livid this afternoon. Vicky, real name John Thompson, who was single and no surprise, noticed fellow bubble friends were invading her newly built bar after spending hours building it into her own backyard. She tried to grab a shot, but the pissed bartender was too busy pouring free shots for other distance guests and assumed she was posing for the camera.
Come on, Teb. Seven in the bow. No, it's a vigil. Can I just say, I actually built this bar. Can I have a fucking drink? I'll have it. No. Oh, there. I got one. Oh, cheers. You have to come down the bar. That's it, you have to come down the bar, David. Come get a shot.
£2, please.
Aye, it's me in the camera. Social gathering.
Someone said,
can
we
see
the
bar?
It's like serving up pride for
the
man.
It is, then. Oh, I'll have a man.
Staying on Vicky Paris, Vicky attracted the media with her drunken date to pretend to hop on a bus to look for her tabs. She says she left them on the back seat whilst on her way to work. Much to the bemusement of the bus driver, Vicky dared herself to ask the bus driver if he was single.
Still ahead on News at 10, Plop is awakened through the night by an intruder, Gladys Duffy in shock and viral video, and supermarket sweep take place in North Shields. Join us both after the break.
This is a vital update about coronavirus.
To help save lives, stay at home. Anyone can spread coronavirus. You should now only go out when absolutely necessary for food, medicine, work, or exercise. Always try to stay 2 meters apart. Do not meet others outside your household, even friends and family.
Stay home. Protect the NHS.
Welcome back. Probelina Shitstorm was awakened by loud noises the other night. Plop woke and wondered where the noise was coming from and heard the noises getting louder and looked out of his window to find a homeless guy claiming to have lost the keys to his outside home. Plop gave the bloke a proper eviction notice and some words which sent him on his way.
Oh! Stop going through the bins, you weird twat! You're being really weird because you were going through the bins.
Builder Ian Black did a neck a full can energy drink challenge on his work break today. Blackie reports on his typical day and makes some nominations on who should follow him and do the challenge.
Just on my little break from the morning. Now I'm going to do my neck nomination of a kind of original 35 pence energy drink. So here we go. Right. So I'd like to nominate none of yous, you deluded bastards. Keep it off me Facebook along with that flapping fucking birds, you deranged bastards. Have a good Wednesday. Ta-da.
Sports news briefly, and Ian Black's brother, Stephen Black, had a shot at riding the bullseye uptown just before the lockdown started. Blackie Two Half Cut bragged his brother and his mates that he could not ever fall off a bull, and he said if he succeeds, the group have to get him a pint on each round.
Fucking hell! You can't even get on the cunt! Oh, hey, Blackie!
What happened here?
Oh, hey! You're not even on the cunt yet! Oh, hey! Oh, we're funny! He's not getting on that, mate.
No, I think we're going to have to help him.
He's not getting on that, is he?
Go on then, get on.
All right, get on the cunt then. Yeah. Get in!
Oh,
we're funny, eh?
What? Come on, you help me. Oh, right. Where's Laura? Hello, Laura.
Come on, you help me.
Hold on.
You can't even get on the cunt. Alright, Peter, help him on.
Any chance to get them off? Can I get on
him? Nice leg! Yes, he's on! Well done, Peter! Yeah, fatty, you've got no chance of lasting the alley. Oh, he's awesome, he's hanging out with him. What a fucking man. Go on, Blackie, you right now? Go on, Blackie.
Hello, Laura.
Go on.
Hello, Laura.
He's off. He's shit at this. Fucking whoa. What the fuck? Get back on.
How did you get hooked?
Yeah. Get back on! What the f...
Back on!
Yeah! Get back on! It's shitty! Better show him how it's done. You're right, Mongy, like.
Back to
you. Me? Me? Fuck!
What have I already paid for it, man? The bastard, it's pissing too.
North Shields barmaid Melissa Young took a week off work recently to fund a special one-off North Shields supermarket sweeper. Now, Kel's missus became the first woman ever to front the game show. Melissa gave the four contestants 3 minutes each to fill their trolleys high as they can as they enter any of the shops in the town centre, including the phone shops. Melissa's shopping list was other tasks for contestants total to bring 3 items to win a bonus free meal at the Pawburn, all compliments of the host herself. The 3 items were 1 cucumber, 1 handsome hunk, and a pair of hinky handcuffs. Melissa reports on how they got on. Carol Brown regains the Lane 7 Open Bowling Championship last week despite being behind with her low scores.
Carol, who's also Kirsty's dearest mother, is over the moon and she went down to see her at the match.
What's the issue? What's the issue, Carol? What's the issue with me score? I'm not cheating. They're saying how have I got 45? Just studying that board. Like, honest to God. I can't cheat, I didn't put the score on the telly. In the gutter. See, this is why I'm winning.
Gladys, aka Nathan Lowe, took part in a binge drinking documentary to help tackle alcohol, how drink has a major effect on some people's lives. Gino's Wishlist star Gladys gave News at 10 special permission to show this disgraceful ranny behaviour.
A recap of the main headlines. David Dale makes an appeal to help retrieve his ex-boyfriend's belongings. Matty Crato shocks Newcastle with a secret confession. Marcus Mitchell surprises Damien, the man of his dreams. And Miss Tesco star Callum Richards has found a faster answer to budget taxis.
And finally, Pebble Dash is finally glad to be back at work. Pebble, alias Leon Torrance, returned to the yard, being the hostess from tonight, showing and guiding people to queue for a drink and make sure they are safely seated.
What do you want?
We just want to say to everyone, stay safe and please keep a 2 metre safe distance where possible. Keep washing your hands and wear a face covering on public transport and in shops, as this is now mandatory by law. Take care and see you soon. Thank you for watching. From Richard and from me, take care and have a good night.